r/AskReddit. What's that one thing you thought everybody did, but it turns out only you do? I regularly shower in the dark. I told some friends this and they looked at me like I was crazy. I thought surely other people enjoyed it too. Weird thing is I am terrified of the dark in every other situation. Black showers are awesome. So relaxing. Have you ever tried a sensory deprivation tank? It's entirely possible. Have water gun fights on Easter. I thought all families celebrated Easter that way, but it turns out only mine does. It all started when my mom would wake up my older siblings with a squirt gun before handing them Easter baskets, and they ended up saving their money to buy guns for themselves. Long story short, 20 plus years later my family still goes all out and gets super soakers for everyone, and I've never known anything else. It's actually a tradition in Poland. We do water fights on Easter Mondays. Close my ducking bedroom door shut. Not my story, but I guess it's count. My friend told me that she thought bananas, maybe another fruit, I don't really remember, are spicy. Turned out she just was allergic to them. Dude, this tomato is spicy as duck. UHH. That's actually a habanero. I used to think everyone could put sunscreen on their own backs. Turns out I'm hypermobile in most of my joints. I had only seen women getting their dresses zipped up by their husbands in opulent bedrooms on nighttime soap type TV shows, so I got the idea it was some sort of sexy flirting. So when I grew up and co-workers or random women asked me or others to zip them up, it seemed super freaky. But I guess not everyone can reach their back. I have never been unable to zip a dress. I can put sunscreen on my own back too. Count the number of chews on each side of my mouth to make sure they're even. I really thought this wasn't that weird until I brought it up and everyone was like, UHH. I used to do something similar but with my feet when I was little. When I started walking after stopping or sitting, I always would try to step with the opposite foot that I ended on so both legs would get equal use. Daydreaming constantly and to the point I feel like I'm not even in my own body anymore and it feels like my mind is slipping away from me. Me too. I feel like I sometimes go over memories and replace them with my own imagination of what happened. Now it's really hard for me to tell if it's memory or imagination and it's super frustrating. Colon. Eat the end piece in the loaf of bread. There isn't anything wrong with it. It's just a piece of bread. No one I know eats the end piece and just throws it out. When my daughter was younger, she would refuse to eat the end pieces because they were gross. So, when making a sandwich, I started turning the bread's end piece facing inwards. She never noticed. I put my hand on my cereal before adding milk so it doesn't raise and risk overflowing on the edges of the bowl. Maybe it's normal, but the one time I did it at a sleepover, a friend looked at me like I just cured cancer. Now I'm just picturing someone pouring milk on the top of their hand and it splashes everywhere. Wiping your butt while standing after you poop. I thought everyone did that until I talked to my girlfriend about pooping habits and she told me she wipes sitting down. Imagine fake celebrity interviews with me as the guest in my head. It's all just a big exercise in narcissism for me. I do something similar, but it is to have an answer to why I do the things I do. I see it as self-reflection. I didn't realize other people got pictures in their mind. I never really have. I thought mind's eye and picture this were figures of speech. Turns out they're not. I didn't wear underwear until I was like 10. Tapping beats of a song with my teeth. I know. I'm weird. I did this when I was like 6-11 years old. Don't bully me about this lol. I slept with 3 pillows. Why? Well, I had one between my legs, one in my arms and one that I put my head on. I don't know why, but I always thought my kindergarten friends did this. When I woke up, then the 3 pillows were always on the ground for some reason. I told it to my friends at kindergarten and they thought I was so weird. It was probably good for your spine. And if you grow up to have wide hips and sleep on your side, it will be good for your spine again. A pillow between my knees sometimes helps with not hurting my back from contorting. I can give myself goosebumps by what feels like flexing my neck shoulders. I thought this was a common trait up until recently. Haven't found anyone else that can do it yet. And that the expression gave me goosebumps was stupid. Daydream obsessively. I can't explain how much I daydream. I realized a few days ago that I daydream to the point it might be unhealthy. Constantly worrying and ruminating. Literally thought that's normal until I told my ex-girlfriend and best friend. They both said they don't do it. When someone is talking about something and they say a word that's not very familiar to me, I try to spell it in my head and then check later whether it was correct or not. I've been using the phrase coffee up for about 20 years now. I say it with the same intensity as Sir Mix-a-Lot in the song My Posse's on Broadway at the end when they say, posse up. So every morning I tell my cubemate that, it's time to coffee up, and go about my business. Well, one day my manager said, I'm going to coffee up, as Deep Root says. So I asked, am I the only person that says that? And everyone within earshot said a resounding, yes, shock and awe, I tell ya, shock and awe. Count stairs and tiles and manipulate the numbers to equal 18. There's 9 stairs, just pretend there's double and count each one as 2. Everything has to equal 18, okay, or it bothers me. Golden birthdays. When I was growing up, it was a huge deal in the family. Golden birthday is when your age matches the birthday. That is, my birthday is on the 11th, so my golden birthday was when I was 11. We got a huge gift and everyone always looked forward to it. I passed it on to my kids. But my wife and now my kids' spouses and everyone else I've talked to have pretty much no idea this ever existed. Sum the digits of a car's registration number, and if the result is even, it's cool, but I can't stand if it's odd. Draw the numeral 5 in a single stroke, bottom to top. Thought it was totally normal until my wife, who is a primary school teacher, saw me do it and looked at me aghast. I do single stroke, but top to bottom. Creating some convoluted rule or set for how to walk across sections on the sidewalk and then having people by you asking why you are walking strangely. Not so much anymore, but when I was younger I used to always start walking with my right foot and always take my last step with my left foot. It had to be an even number of steps. I also despise volume controls that work in a number sequence because the volume always has to be on an even number. Used to be that whatever I did with my right side of the body I had to do with my left side of the body or else I felt uneven. I also used to take words, replace them with their number and then add the numericals together. So for instance, as would be 1 plus 19, A equals 1 plus S equals 19. So as is 20, if I came up with a number that wasn't a single digit I would then add said numbers together until it was a single digit. So 11 would turn into 2 and then I would be done. Thinking about random stuff in family relations. I don't know how to explain properly, but for example if I eat a bigger grape then it's a mother and let's say another one is also big then it's also a mother, but a smaller one is a daughter. Or let's say I'm looking at tops in the shop and one top looks like a mother and another like a son. It happens unconsciously and I catch myself doing it at work the most. I knew a guy in high school who wore underwear for a few days before switching to a new pair. He mentioned it offhandedly and was blown away when he was told that it wasn't normal. When my brother started kindergarten, our mom would tell him every day to put on clean underwear. One day he came home from school and she noticed that his butt looked really big. He had been putting the clean underwear on over his dirty underwear and was wearing like 8 pairs at once. I didn't know being ambidextrous was rare for a long time as a kid. I primarily write with the left hand. So if I'm sitting next to the right of someone, our elbows usually keep bumping into each other. Countless times as a kid I've told people just use your other hand. Imagine that I would eat somebody else's ear. I get a serious headache and also heartburns after I've had hot dogs and this pain usually lasts for a couple of hours. What makes it even worse is the fact that it doesn't put me off. It does sound like you're mildly allergic to some ingredient. You might want to have that checked by a doctor. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.